Action 7 News had the only helicopter in the sky touring the flood-damaged areas.
Yeah, we take you for a ride in the Sky 7 right now.
You know, as we were flying along trying to get north up to Las Vegas this morning, the visibility in several places was not real good. Now, the view that we have from Sky 7 shows it a little bit worse than it really was, but it was still very difficult to get around. We flew over the arroyo that empties out just south of the Cottonwood Mall at Coors, and the water was coming down in pulses. I mean, there was wave after wave after wave of water coming down that arroyo, and it was running from bank to bank. A lot of water flow very, very fast. We flew over the western part of Rio Rancho, and a number of the arroyos were running very fast. There was one up in the Northern Meadows area that had some spectacular water fountains, almost looked like, as it was coming through the arroyo near the bridge. And the interesting thing was the people that were standing there taking pictures and just kind of enjoying the view. Well, we flew northbound along the Rio Grande, and as we passed many of the Pueblo communities, we noticed that there was just a lot of water coming off the mesas to the west. I don't believe I've ever seen that much water flowing off the mesas. Several places there were actually large lakes that were spilling over the edge of the mesa, and just spectacular looking waterfalls from Algodones all the way up past White Rock Canyon. Well, when we arrived in Las Vegas, we saw immediately there was one house that we saw that was surrounded on three sides by water. The folks there were trying to sandbag the area, and it looked like they were fighting a losing battle. I don't know if that house was going to be flooded or not, but they were putting out an awful lot of effort trying to save it. Reporting from Sky 7, this is Neil Lawson, KOAT Action 7 News.